I am very excited to announce that Korda are releasing their first ever carp fishing rods and landing net. The Kaizen and the Spring Bow are amazing bits of kit, built to the very highest standards. In this video, I'm going to tell you everything you need to know to put them into your fishing. The first thing that sets the Kaizen rod range aside from pretty much every other rod on the market is the high modulus carbon. There was no way that we were going to get into rods unless we could get access to the absolute top materials. And the high modulus carbon means you need less of it to make the same test curve of rod. So the rod is lighter for the same test curve. That means it moves through the air easier and it's just generally nicer to use. There's lots of rods out there that are lower modulus carbon, which makes them quite heavy when they're in your hand, makes them harder to move through the air, but also it makes them break down quicker. So they'll go soft in 2 or 3 years, where these will stay pretty much as crisp as you first use them for several years afterwards. That is coupled with a special material that stops the blank from twisting. So when it comes back completely straight. That means it goes exactly where you aim it. And once you've used these rods, you go back to another rod, it feels like they're folding backwards in all sorts of funny angles and the lead goes everywhere. So once you get used to them, they are far more accurate. But for me, they make long distance casting easy. I am not a massive caster. 130, 140 against the clip with pinpoint accuracy is about my limit. These will make long range fishing much, much easier. And also accurate fishing much, much easier. They're built with really low surface area rings from Sea Guide. That makes the rod lighter still. They're single leggers on the tip, and then a 50mm butt ring, three legger, and a 40mm next one up, three legger, just to give it more rigidity and a bit more strength in the middle of the rod. Again, it makes the rod move through the air that much quicker. It feels so light. When you pick it up in the tackle shop, it almost feels like there's no eyes on there at all. The tip rings are obviously ceramic because they take most of the wear and tear of the line coming backwards and forwards, and the tip rings are huge. We all use heavy lines nowadays, but it makes so much difference having big rings and big tip rings. They're built in a very custom sort of style, so they're very minimal, matte black, black whippings, little tiny bits of stainless on them, lovely butt cap with the Korda logo in it. So they look like a custom built rod. That was really, really important to me. I'm looking at a set on the rest now and they look absolutely beautiful. Now the range, 12 foot 3 pound, which is good for everything up to about 110 yards, 120 yards with pinpoint accuracy. If you're going on a field and put an 8 pound line on them, you'll be able to cast them 140 yards, but I'm talking about in a real fishing situation. If you fish up to about 110 most of the time, you fish little lakes all the time, you're using slightly smaller leads, sort of 2s to 3.5s, then that is the rod for you. The next one up is a 12 foot 3.5. That is my all-rounder. That's what I use 99% of the time. And it'll do everything from underneath your feet to out to 120 yards, again with pinpoint accuracy. And I'm probably using either 035 fluorocarbon or 040 long chuck on those rods most of the time. Then you've got a 12 foot 4 pound, which is a proper animal. You know, that's going to put a lead 150 with ease, especially if you've got the tapered line on. We wanted to do a more stepped up rod in 12 foot for people that felt the 12 foot 3.5 just wasn't quite pokey enough. And then we go up to a 12 foot 6. It's what I'm using here now. I absolutely love them. They're a great step up from a 12 foot. They don't really feel any longer than a 12 foot. And I'm sure some of you will have tried to go from a 12 to a 13 and found them too cumbersome, too heavy, too hard to cast, and wish you hadn't moved up. These 12 foot 6 4 pounders are the perfect interim. And again, you could fish them under your feet up to sort of 150, you know, if you've got my sort of casting capabilities, with pinpoint accuracy. And that's so important. There's no point just thrashing it out there. It has to be dropping on that spot. So if you're going to fish consistently over 100 yards, but sometimes you're going to fish closer, that 12 foot 6 4 pounder is what I'd recommend. Then there's a 13 foot 3.5, which is a lovely rod for playing fish. It will still cast a hell of a long way, But if you want to use 13s, you don't want something so pokey, that would be the rod for you. And then there's a 13-foot 4-pound, and that's probably the longest distance casting rod. You know, it will handle leads of 4.5, 4¾, maybe 5 ounces in the right hands. Personally, a 4 and a 4.5 is best for me, and I've used those up to about 140 yards, again with pinpoint accuracy. So if you love 13-footers, I've got mates who are big range anglers, they love 13-footers, they've used them, and now they would never use anything else. There's a 12-foot spod as well. I know it's a lot of money for a spod rod, but if you can't get your bait out to the same distance as your rigs, then you're not fishing properly. So having a spod rod with that super fast recovery that they've all got, because they're all fast taper, that high modulus carbon, they're built exactly the same as the fishing rods, so they look absolutely top end, so easy to move through the air. If you're going to fish with a 12-foot rod, coupling it with a 12-foot spod rod is just an absolutely awesome setup. So that is the range as it starts. There will be more rods coming in the future, but for now, I think we've got everything from 1 yard to 160 yards pretty much covered. And if you're wondering what Kaizen means, it's derived from a Japanese word and it means constantly evolving. And that is what we will do with the range. As the technology improves, we will keep putting it into the rods to make them easier and easier to cast so they go further and further distances. And another product you will have seen me using for the last 2 or 3 years at least is the Spring Bow landing net. You can tell I'm using them because the handle does not bend at all when you're netting a fish. We've all had it where you've got super thin nets, you push the net through the water trying to net the fish, the net's bending over and it's just not going in there quick enough. And this is Damien's design, my right-hand man at Korda. Anything that he designs is absolutely top of the tree. He will not let it go until it is perfect, because that is how he fishes. They're super, super lightweight. They're reverse tapered. They've got a lovely stainless spike on the end, so you can stick them in the margins and feel carpy if you want to retain the fish for a little bit. I didn't used to do that, but now I've got those nets, so I have to admit I do it, and it is really handy. The spreader block weighs absolutely nothing. The arms weigh absolutely nothing. It's got a beautiful bow in it. You know, the arms are in there just under enough tension. They go in and out of the spreader block really, really easily. And because the net is hollow and it's wider at the spreader block end than it is at the other end, the net floats without a net float, which is a great little feature if you're wading out into the edge and taking your net with you.
Bosh!
It's just sitting there on the surface. It moves through the water so easily, doesn't bend one bit. It's just an absolute thing of beauty. And it comes in three different sizes, 42 inches, which is what I'm using here, 46 inch and 52. If you want to use top of the range kit, that is what you've got to bag.
Gotcha.
You will find loads of videos on YouTube featuring the Kaizen rods and the spring bow nets. Have a search around for those and see them getting put through their paces. They are out in tackle shops now. I strongly recommend you go in and have a look. One of them will definitely suit your fishing.